My name is Tomas Wenger. I'm from Collabora and I live in Slovenia, but currently I'm living a little bit in Japan. I soon return to Slovenia. So, a little bit about me. I've been a LibreOffice contributor for about 6 years. And I joined Collabora Productivity in 2014 to work as a member there. I'm also a member of the design team, mainly as a developer that collaborates with the design team and says if a certain thing is possible or not to implement. And I'm a all-around developer, which I don't want to focus on anything, particularly inside LibreOffice like art or writer. I just want to work anything that I can. But I focus mainly, if there is some focus, then this is focus on graphic and to get the graphics better. Work better inside LibreOffice. So this is mainly the domain of VCL module. So a little bit about me, what contributions I made in the past. I just made this list off my head. I didn't know which exactly, so this is probably not the complete list. One of the things is, for example, is the regression curves for the chart module, then pivot charts, which is a recent addition. Then I implemented document encryption and decryption for OXML. This wasn't yet present, so I just saw that a lot of people want this, and in my free time I just gone and implemented this. Then this is next thing, are like statistic dialogues, which are dialogues for some statistic computation inside Calc. Were also missing, so a lot of people requested it and I added it. Image compression dialogue is also something that was missing and it was present in Microsoft Office, so I went and implemented it. Non-linear swarm solver, this is a recent addition, maybe a lot of people don't even know about this. Previously we had just linear solver inside LibreOffice, and if you wanted a non-linear you had to install an extension NLP solve. Now I implemented a non-linear solver which is default inside LibreOffice. I'll talk about this later. Then advanced dialog for TSTP classification, this I'll talk about later. OpenGL, VCL, I was working OpenGL, VCL, backend, LibreOffice viewer for Android, and Collabora Online, and a lot of small things that, here and there. So, about this talk, I decided that I will talk about a little bit my experience with developing LibreOffice 6.0 or things that I'm familiar with. This is a lot of very different things, like from design, from what I was working on for Collabora, or what I was working on just some at a site of the main work for Glabra as volunteer. So first thing about something, some significant work before LibreOffice 6.0 that I met, but I think it's very important addition to LibreOffice. So the pivot charts, they were added in LibreOffice 5.4, but I decided to again mention them because this is quite important for the future. That's this work as forums of Batmans. This is a city in South France, and I said this is a major feature that is lacking in LibreOffice, but there is this feature is in Microsoft Office, so they said they contacted Collabora and said if we implemented this feature. So what they are is generally just charts that adapt themselves to automatically to the pivot table changes. So a little bit. Show this. So we have this row that we have some pivot table, and now we can just insert a pivot chart. So this is now pivot chart. Just if you click on the on the pivot table set and say okay insert the chart, it will insert a pivot chart. And now this pivot chart, if you change something, for example delete one parameter, then it will automatically adjust. Okay, now I'll be talking a little bit about LibreOffice 6. What I was doing for this, this is then the TSTP classification. This was already present before LibreOffice 6.0, but what I did is more or less an improvement of it. So this work was sponsored by Dutch military. Previously, it was a little bit confusing it was good for Dutch military, but a little bit confusing for other users because you had three kinds of classification, and what you just usually want is just one type of classification. This is intellectual property. You want to mark a document if it's classified or just internal only. So this was simplified, and now we just have this one option. But we added another option where you can, it's a more strict control, you have more custom control what you can do. And this was done by me. In addition, there was also added a paragraph classification and signing. So signing per paragraph level is quite interesting. You can sign just one paragraph, and user cannot, or then can see if this just one paragraph was changed externally or not. So this is quite interesting feature. So I'll just quickly demonstrate this. Now I'm going to want to save it. So this DSCP feature is in toolbar. DSCP classification. So there is now just this one level, as I said, and you can just mark it confidential, for example, and it will change this the document as a confidential. So this can be all. There is an XML file which defines what should happen if this is marked as confidential. So these are all just default values. So what was added is like this document classification where you can a little bit more fine-tune, specify what should go inside the headers, for example. So now this was changed exactly as it should be, because now I have this strict control over classification. As per, if you have a paragraph, a second paragraph, now also the classification is per paragraph, which is done with this option. And you can just apply it. Like not doing business, okay, just say internal only. And just one, this paragraph will be marked as internal inside. So, and at the same time you can also sign this paragraph. So this is quite a neat feature. For especially for businesses, not so much for the home users. Okay, I'll talk about a little bit non-linear swan server that I added. This is my free time. As I said already before, previously we had this NLP solver that was Java-based. You can still use it. It's still, I think, a little bit better than the swan solver. The swan solver itself is experimental for now, but I'm still working on it to get a little bit better results, or at least equal results than NLP solver. Maybe at the end I will do a demonstration. So one good feature that was implemented by Armin Legrand, and I was in the past very annoyed by it, so that I implemented some intermediate solution where we can just protect the image. So right, what the problem is, Writer previously didn't have the possibility to rotate the image how we wanted. So it was always 0 degree rotation. So I was annoyed with this and implemented some intermediate solution that would uselessly rotate the image 90 degrees, 180 degrees, 270, but not arbitrary angle. So this was now implemented by Armin Legrand, and it's quite a nice feature. However, there is still the problem is that was previously is that because we had this writer image handling and image handling, formal image handling, which was separately. So this common image handling could handle this scenario, but not the writer image handling. So now writer image handling has this, but the problem is still that we don't have a common image handling as it should be. And there's no reason we should handle images differently in writer than we should that we are in other modules, other components. So other upcoming things for LibreOffice 6.1 that was happening. Now for quite some time I'm working to rework the graphic handling. This is mainly an under the hood change. For the users it shouldn't be much difference, but it's a quite important feature that we are getting now, because sometimes in the past it could happen that some images get lost because the lifecycle management was not very good. Now we are doing the proper lifecycle management and there is less risk that when you open the document the images will be gone. This was sponsored by TDF and it was quite a big chunk of work to handle it. There is also API changes, UNA API changes, so it's good if you check what was changed if you are using, for example, macros or extensions that use images. Now, what was also done with this is the memory management was simplified, so previously we just counted how many memory each image takes now and we could decide to put these images to the disk to save memory space. Now this is done similarly, but previously it could happen that if you are using a lot of memory and using the images at the same time, you could go into the swap route where images would be swapped to the disk and then go back and swap to the disk and back. So this was now improved. There is added common lazy loading of images. So if you open a document, you don't load all the images into the memory. This is not good. If you have a very big document, it will eat all your memory just for the images. So first, now how we do is that we just mark these images to be loaded, but we don't load it directly. These are done before, but again, this was done for writer separately and for other common components separately. So now this is all common code, and even like OXML supports now, loading OXML document supports now this, and also RTL and HTML, which previously wasn't done. This also opens a lot of new ideas and to how to improve the performance, because if you have a very big image, it will slow down rendering a bit. So I think now that we have done this, we can improve the performance quite significantly. There are very good ideas on how to get this done. Then the dialog tunneling, which is implemented for Collabora Online. This is I started working on this feature from quite some time, but mostly it was done by Pranav Pant. It's a very important feature for LibreOffice Online. Collabora Office has it now. LibreOffice Online will get it. And this is so that you can show a dialogue inside the web instance, which is a very important feature because it enables a lot of more features that were previously not available in online. So, to know what I'm talking about, that was my question. So I have this Collabora online and previously it wasn't possible. For example, if you have something like this text, what you cannot do is go to ISO, this should be right here, and have this dialogues like character and you can change. Oh, it's a little bit deep. But you get, as you see, this is not a dialogue that is directly from LibreOffice, and it's the same one that is in LibreOffice. So the users cannot change with this, a lot of these additional features that previously were impossible and apply it. I could too. Let's try this one. Okay, now we changed it to the bullet. So for the end, I'll talk about the UI changes that were as part of the design team. In LibreOffice 6, there is a notebook bar available, so this is an alternative for the Ribbon UI. So it should be a very important feature for this. The people that fall from Microsoft Office, so they have a little bit familiar user interface. For the LibreOffice 6.0, this was experimental, it still is inside master currently, but we are slowly getting that we have a little bit, at least features of the notebook are ready to be released. Maybe 6.1, but we'll see. I'll try this now on the master to see, to maybe show. Okay, what I want to show is how it currently looks. We have many options now, mainly this I think that top interface. This is how it looks like now, and Atari looks much better than it was in LibreOffice 6.0. The problem is that we have to implement this for other components as well. Writer it was done first, so this is the most most stable. So the next thing was this new master. Just I continue that master is because there is one top level icon theme that we have in LibreOffice, which was previously Galaxy. Now this icon theme will be probably replaced by Colibre. The main reasons for this is that there is no, this in the Galaxy icon theme, there is no, there are no, not icons that have SVG sources. So because we are now moving to SVG icon support, we need those. And so this new icon theme Colibre was created for as a default for Windows, but it probably also used in different environments, mainly because it uses this Microsoft UI color palette. So this is why it looks very familiar inside Windows. So the next, the last thing is the SVG icon support. I'm working on this and hope I'll get this for LibreOffice 6.1. It's already present, but the icons itself are not turned on for with the SVG support. They are not even shipped with LibreOffice currently. So for 6.1, I hope we'll get this in, so we have get better rendering at the edge, high DPI. Which currently has this, the icons are blurred, and of course the, because the SVG in smaller size than before PNG icons. So I'm looking forward to this. And maybe just to demonstrate, yeah, so the icons I'm talking, the icons I'm talking about are these icons, which was a bit. These are the new ones. I think they look quite nice. So. Very major that I see is that the LibreOffice interface looks like old, and I think these icons have like quite a big impact for getting a little bit fresh. Okay, this is all I had today. Thank you for listening.
Can I ask one question? So you mentioned some sponsors for your work, for example, Nantes City of France or Dutch Military. Can you mention any other sponsors you can share?
Not for the work, at least I'm not aware for this work that not don't have sponsors. It's either we are doing it ourselves or I'm doing it in my free time with help of other contributors. So I'm not sure which sponsors that Dutch Military for this work, but Dutch Military, Nantes, the TDF itself, but there are also other sponsors that contribute to this. I'm just up to date with which work was sponsored by which sponsor.
So, and you have mentioned the new non-linear solver, SWAM solver. So,
new
non-linear SWAM solver.
Yes.
Yeah. So, which is you develop it, driven by your interest.
Yeah, this is by my interest. I saw that we don't have a SWAM non-linear solver inside LibreOffice. The only one that is NLP solver, which was Java-based. And I think that a lot of people out there don't want to install Java anymore, so I saw this, okay, I'll try and get one non-linear solver inside that is good enough for a lot of people. This is why my main motivation, I was I implemented this one solver.
That's technically impressive and interesting, I think.
Yeah, yes. But it's still not, generally I didn't know that it's so easy to make it with this. The algorithm is not so complicated itself. I was very interested before in differential evolution of the algorithm. So I thought to make a solver, non-linear solver, it involves a differential evolution. So this is. Then I tried and investigated what can be done here. And then I saw that a lot of new now use particle swarm algorithm, and then I also implemented that one. But currently the solver is still experimental. I just didn't use a lot of scenarios for the solver. So for now I said it's should be a little bit experimental and get some feedback from people and see what I can do to improve it.
Okay. That means so you encourage these people to use and try the feature, right?
Yes.
Yes. Thank you.
Hoka, I didn't choose. ないですかね。
講演の内容とは直接関わりのないものというのを良かったりするんですか。質問してみてください。はい。ぜひ。まあ、まあ、英語が通じるかどうかちょっと分かんないですけど、
ちょっと are you interested in open office basic?
Like macro? For macros? Open office?
Yes. I'm interested in the name binding of variables, functions, and methods. I try to some variables with Unicode characters, but macros can't accept it.
Yes.
Probably you know Microsoft Excel can do it, but Open LibreOffice or Open Office cannot accept as cannot accept Unicode characters as variables or function or methods name. Is it planned to update Unicode characters enabled?
I don't know for anybody any plan for this. I wasn't even aware of this problem, but I see this can be a big problem for when writing macros. If you don't have Unicode support. So no, I don't think there is any plan, not for now. But we can talk later on about this.
Thank you very much. Sorry to have a poor English.
なければ、友達さんどうもありがとうございました。次は